Hello everyone, it's Ryan with SRG, or SReaper G, or just Ryan. And today, we're talking about, you guessed it, Mass Effect. Surprise, surprise, no, not really. That's why you're here, I think. Who doesn't want to hear me grasp at every little bit of Mass Effect news that comes out in publications and websites? Seriously, subscribe. Anyway, none other than Henry Cavill has stated that he would be totally down to star in the new Mass Effect series. I know this news is maybe like a couple days late or like a week late, but I find it interesting considering he's teased a Mass Effect project before, and this adds some more meat onto this story that is building of Amazon's potential Mass Effect series, and I wanted to talk about this because I think it's an interesting story to track. Especially if you love Mass Effect, and I assume if you're on this channel that you do. There's a lot that we don't know that happens behind the scenes here. We know conversations are being had, deals are being made, and handshakes are happening in private places. Sometimes, oftentimes, money is involved. Now, based on Henry Cavill's comments, I would love to have him attached to this project because he seems to have an affinity for the source material, or at least is familiar with it. During recent press rounds for The Witcher Season 2, GamesRadar asked Cavill whether he'd be open to taking the reins of a Mass Effect series. His answer? Yes. With one caveat. Very much so, yeah. All depending on how they're executing it. Cavill says, the world of adaptation can be heavy or light. When I like a product, I prefer the adaptation to be less changed from the source, so it all depends. Cavill continues, I think it's found a home, hasn't it? If the series finds a home, I would love to have a conversation. For his part, Cavill's a big fan of the Mass Effect series and even recapped his past history with the BioWare franchise for us. I did not play Andromeda. I had a go at it, but ended up being very busy. But the Mass Effect trilogy? Yeah, loved it. Brilliant games, Cavill says before adding, it would make such a magnificent series or movies of movies or TV shows. First, I'll just say he didn't really play Andromeda. Yeah, listen, you're not missing much, my friend. You're good. It's not terrible, but it ain't great either. So don't worry, Henry. You're good. We got your back here. That's not a lot here, of course, though. There's not a lot that he says here in terms of what the show is going to be or if he knows anything about it, or if they're even already talking about what is going to happen with the show. But on the one hand, it seems like he does like the games and has played them. We already know that with The Witcher, Henry Cavill pushed the showrunners to just be a bit more book accurate for Geralt. But he says here, well, if they do it, I would want it to be as accurate to the source material as possible. Now again, we talked about this last time with the Mass Effect series about how David Gaider, who was the lead writer on all the Dragon Age games, obviously, not there now since he's left, he shared some concerns he had about this potential series, and we talked about them here on this channel. You can actually refer to that video if you want to hear my full thoughts on that, but I even think some of what he says is right. The most fundamental thing, again, I think Gaider nails is that any series, whether it's telling a story that's adapted from the games or something in the universe, needs to answer the fundamental question of the entire series that you get in Mass Effect 1, but you may not get in a show. Is what is Mass Effect? Now, if we're just going off of Henry Cavill, it sounds like he has respect for the world of Mass Effect and even wants something that's true to the source material. And you guys know, I think there's plenty of stories in the Mass Effect universe that can be explored and potentially be very cool. So when I think Henry Cavill wants it to be true to the source material, meaning he only wants to adapt the games, I don't think he means it that way. I think he just means that he wants it to stay true to the ideas and the themes of the universe and at least be accurate to some of the stories they've already told. If you watch my other videos, you know, but I'll explain to you anyway. My opinion on it is essentially that they should try and stay away from the games in the series if they can, because I don't really get what is being gained by telling the story of the Mass Effect trilogy. But now all of that interactivity, what made the game so great, is kind of lost in that passive medium that is films and TV. You don't really get to interact or decide the outcome. It just wouldn't feel right to me, or at least it wouldn't feel the same, and it would be missing that, I guess, for lack of a better way of describing it, that it factor. Does that make sense to even say? Would Henry Cavill make a good Commander Shepard? Of course he would. I'm not saying he wouldn't. I'm sure there's many actors that would make a great Shepard, but it's more that Shepard, at least in the games, is meant to be that surrogate character that you as the player kind of project yourself onto as you understand and navigate the world of Mass Effect. And when you interact with companions and characters, that's kind of the point of Mass Effect, and that's what makes it so special in a way. I think you'd lose some of that specialness, or specialness, you lose that with a show that follows the characters but doesn't have that interactivity and choice. Now, losing that doesn't doom the series by any means, and it doesn't mean you can't do it. It just means you'll kind of miss that, and that's one of the reasons we all kind of got involved in Mass Effect, or invested, I should say, that you could project yourself onto a character that is very much a blank slate otherwise. Cavill's involvement is interesting as far as this whole show goes, or the project of Mass Effect, because we all know that the whole thing from back in February, and if you don't, I'll tell you now, when he teased a Mass Effect project on Instagram. The image in question being this. Now, obviously, on the set of The Witcher, he is, and getting his hair and makeup done, gotta make him all pretty and witchery. Pretend I didn't say that. And then whatever script he is reading, or packet of papers for a secret project, or just for old funsies, he's reading something like that. The words can be pointed out, or were pointed out by Game Pressure. Cerberus, Reaper, Geth, they came in and they unblurred the shot a bit with some little effects, and even found that it was an excerpt exactly from the Mass Effect 3 wiki. The excerpt reading as, "Following the events on Tuchanka and a failed coup by Cerberus to take over the Citadel, the Quarians offer their support to the Alliance if Shepard helps them reclaim their homeworld, Rannoch, from the Geth. Assisted by a Quarian, either Tali Zora or Admiral Ryle Darrogen, Shepard boards a Geth dreadnought and rescues a captive Geth unit, either Legion or a facsimile occupied by a Geth virtual intelligence, then disables the Reaper control signal over the Geth. Since then, all we have is this potential Amazon series being in the planning phases, or a deal of sorts, or our contract signing, working out the details phase sort of thing, and then Henry Cavill saying if the series is a home and they're ready to start working on it, he would be willing to talk about possibly being in it. And my friends, that is the crux of this small little fairy tale, or tale. Fairy tale seems like it's fake, because it's not. We know these stuff, or these conversations are happening. Now, Henry Cavill could potentially star in yet another popular IP. You have to understand something here, folks. I am but a lowly YouTuber with an incredibly modest subscriber count. Of course, that's not to say anything ill of any of you. I love each of you very, very much. I do. But I don't get inside scoops here. I don't know what the fuck is going on here personally, and no one is going to tell me. No one's calling me up and being like, listen, this is the real deal, obviously. So if you're sitting there saying, I didn't learn anything new here, what the hell? All I can do here for you is pontificate on strange or interesting things happening, and you can look at this whole thing, this whole storyline of the Mass Effect teaser, the potential series, Henry Cavill maybe knowing some things, or is just an avid reader of random Mass Effect Wikipedia entries while he's on the set of The Witcher. It's like having a bunch of pieces to a puzzle and none of it fits. Except it's not a jigsaw puzzle, but its story is connected loosely by one thing. That is Mass Effect. With that, there's really no good way to end this video. This just piqued my interest, and I wanted to talk about it a bit with all of you. My best friends in the whole world. Let me know what you think, of course, though, down below in the comments, or at least just thumbs up the video if you enjoyed it. And of course, if you didn't like it, you can hit that ugly dislike button if you didn't. I know it's ugly and it's gross and none of us like it. I don't like it. But if you feel like this video wasn't your thing and you didn't like it, let me know by hitting it. Subscribe to see more content like this, of course, because really, I will fish for more reasons to talk about Mass Effect any day of the week if I have to. Now, weirdly enough, I haven't had to so far, but really, all I'm trying to say here is thanks for watching, and I'll talk to you all soon. But again, let me know what you think down below. See you later.